We're here for a session about a very wonderful film, a film in a competition here, Two Men in Suits. And I'm very happy to welcome the two main actors, also father and son in real life. And welcome to Josef Bierbichler and Simon Donatz here in Tallinn. Two Men in Suits is a film based on your own book called Mittelreich. And it is not exactly a literate translation, but like a summing up of, or probably selecting from Mittelreich and making a new film out of it. Very specific in that it reflects your own story and three generations and 100 years of German and Bavarian history. Now, people wanted to make this into a movie. I know there were several producers trying to convince you, and there were also several directors wanting to do it, or there was discussions about it. In the end, you decided to do it yourself. And what was the key moment when you said you have to do that yourself?
So it was not clear from the beginning that I would be directing this movie myself. I talked with the producer. Once I had chosen a producer, we talked things over and it went back and forth. And I had one experience with directing a movie 25 or 30 years ago, which was a big hassle. And so I was not necessarily fond of doing it again, but during the talks, we came to the conclusion that it would be best if I would direct the movie myself, not least because I know the material best and I can handle it best.
Maybe this is the motto of all what you've been doing as a actor, as a director, as a writer through the many years of your career, do it yourself. I was talking about a theater play that you did called Holzschlachten, in which basically you're chucking wood for hours, and this is about a physical experience. And so I wanted to know if directing changed you, if there's also an experience that had to be made. What was the experience of doing this film?
I've been a professional actor in both films and theater for over 45 years, and I've got so much experience by now that it's not really a challenge anymore to be just acting, and especially acting in conventional film productions is not enough of a challenge for me anymore. So that's why I decided I have to direct again to have more of a challenge. Directing the movie that I'm acting in is not only a challenge, but it's also more satisfying, and it's something that I wanted to do. I was socialized with Herzog and Achternbusch, and shooting movies with them was always an adventure, but the conventional movies since then have not been as adventurous, and I feel like when I'm directing my own movie, it's a more fulfilling work than just acting.
So the title of the film is very telling. It's Two Men in Suits, and this title describes one central element of the film, that father and son sit together and reflect on family history, on national history or Bavarian history, and their two realities collide. There's one very interesting thing that the casting led you to, casting Simon Donatz, who's your own son, first time actor. And you just said being a director and actor at the same time wasn't actually more stressful. But how was it for you? That would be an additional question. So the first question is, how did this decision come about that you would act together? And how did you perceive the shoot, Simon Donatz?
The film, as you said before, is inspired by the novel. And the novel is inspired by my family history. It's not an autobiographical novel. It's just inspired by the events in my family and both by the last century of German history. So the novel starts in 1914 when I was not yet alive. So it's not an autobiography, but it draws from my own experience. And the reason why the film has a different name than the novel is that I selected some material from the novel, but I didn't translate the novel one-to-one into a motion picture. and the two figures, the two men in suits, are very central in the film, and that's where the title came from. So the decision to cast my son came about when I looked at a picture of the two of us sitting at a table, and I noticed the striking similarities. And then I decided that it would be a good idea, and we tried out whether he could actually act, and he could act, he was able to do it. So we made that decision, and the similarity between the two people in the movie symbolizes or resembles that human development, or the development of individuals, only happens in very, very small steps, especially when you compare it to the development of mankind or even things outside of humans that develop much more drastically than people develop. And we both play, each of us play two generations, two different generations in the movie. So this is how we cover the three generations. Two or three days of shooting were really difficult for me, were really hard. There was the fact that I was new to the business, whereas on set there were 40 people around me who'd done this forever and for whom it was their daily business. In addition to just being new to the project, there was additional pressure because it was my father's project, and I didn't want to disappoint. If it had been a project of some random director, I might not have cared so much about the success of the project as a whole, but because he was my father, I wanted to deliver, and there was some time pressure, we wanted to get it done. And so the first two or three days were really difficult, but then I got used to it, I got more comfortable, and then I actually started to enjoy the process more.
So there's two things I would like to talk about, and you decide what you want to. There's a genre in Germany called the Heimatfilm, talking about one's own country, you could say. How does your film relate to that? That would be the one question, if you want to answer that. Or the other question would be, Two Men in Suits, is it a comedy or is it a tragedy? This is such a rich film, also in a very positive sense, a pastiche, like having very different tones. So how do you think about it? Does it have to be that there's humor and the absolute abyss has to be, when you talk about history, side by side? It feels like a big, the big theater of humanity when you look at your film.
Man kann ja möglicherweise beide Fragen in einen Topf
schmeißen. Sehr gut. Also da,
the term Heimatfilm, a movie about home, about one's native country, doesn't mean much to me. I don't like this term Heimat, home, very much. For me, it has a negative connotation because it's usually directed against people on the outside, against strangers. And even though I myself have a good relation to my home and a comfortable relation to my home, I don't have to bear this in front of me or turn it on the outside. The development was kind of interesting. For me, it was a movie about Bavaria, and the clearest sign of that is that I speak only Bavarian. I have trouble speaking standard German, even though I went to acting school, and in acting school I was forced to learn standard German. It didn't quite work out. I still have difficulty speaking high German, standard German. I usually speak dialect. And it was very clear to me that this movie had to be shot in dialect as well, in the Bavarian dialect. But then the producer wanted to turn it into this very regional Bavarian movie, and that again was not quite big enough for me. I think the story the film tells is bigger than just a Bavarian story. It's more universal, and the project is a bigger one than just a regional story.